أنه الحق.
الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهر على دينه كل وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد الحمد لله for Allah to give us another opportunity that we've seen another year of Islam year 1443 and today is the 7th of Muharram and every year there is rituals the Islamic things we are presented by Allah Rabbul Izzah to cleanse ourselves. And in this month, there's one of the days, very good days to fast because what it does is it cleanses you from the older sins and the common sins. And which is this day is the 10th of Muharram. Alhamdulillah by Allah who gives us these opportunities every year. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he moved to Medina, he saw a small community of people were fasting. And he asked them why. They said, on the 10th of Muharram, Allah saved Musa alayhi salam. And that is why we are fasting. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied back and said, we have more right to fast than anybody else. We are more closer to Musa than anybody else. Musa alayhi salam is a Muslim. Musa alayhi salam, those who are following Musa then were Muslim. That is why Allah saved them from the hand of the tyrant. Firaun, mal'oon, kafir. So we as a Muslim have more right to fast than anybody else out there. And that community who were fasting was the Jewish community, Yahudi community back then were fasting. Now, Allah Rabbul Izzah blessed mankind with every nation a prophet from Adam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last prophet. He was the seal of the prophet. There is no prophet after him at all. Allah Rabbul Izzah said, wa khatamun nabi. He is the last prophet, seal. I repeat. And from Adam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every prophet who came was a Muslim. There is no any another prophet who came with a different religion. Muslim. Isa alayhi salam came, those who follow Isa was a Muslim. Isa is going to come back, he will come back as a follower of Muhammad and he's a Muslim. Dawood alayhi salam, the same. Sulaiman alayhi salam, the same. And those who are following Sulaiman alayhi salam. Zakaria, the same. Yahya, the same. Ishaq. Ismail, Saleh, Hud, Nuh, all of them were Muslim and those who follow them were Muslim. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a Muslim. There are some people out there who says there is faith of Ibrahimic. This is absolutely false. There is nothing called the faith of Ibrahimic. No. Allah says, ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Ibrahim عليه السلام was not a Christian and he was not a Jew. He was a Muslim and he was not from the mushrikun. Ibrahim عليه السلام has no another faith. Those who think is an Abrahamic faith, the Muslims, they have got diluted Aqidah. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a Muslim. He has no another religion. Ibrahim is not a Jewish. Ibrahim is not a Christian. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a Muslim. Clean cut Muslim. Allah says in the verse I've just read in Surah Al-Imran, again, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ما كان إبراهيما يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Ibrahim, he's not a Jew, he's not a Christian and he's not a mushrik. He's a Muslim, pure, black and white. In Dubai you'll find there is a new church which is open. They say it's an Ibrahimic church or masjid, whatever. There's three faith there. There's nothing like that. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a clean cut Muslim. So all the prophets who came were Muslim, absolutely Muslim. So this day of Muharram is a very, very good day to fast. It's a kafara Yani you fast, your sins are being cleansed of the past year and the coming year. So fasted either a day before, which is the day is going to land, is going to be Wednesday. So either you fast on Tuesday and Wednesday, or Wednesday and Thursday, or you fast all the 3 days if you can. Even if you miss your fasting, you can fast. You can have two intentions and fast those 2 days together, or 3 days together. And Allah will reward you, because our religion is based upon your intention. You cannot have a dodgy intention. You have to have a certainty and pure intention. You cannot say my intention is to wear a topi and you don't wear a topi. La. La 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 la. You have the intention, you do it. Your intention would represent the outer side of yours. We ask Allah to make it easy for all the believing men and women. So fasting on this day, it's very, very important for those who have got calamity, who have got sihr, who have got any difficulty. Fast on this day and ask Allah to save you, just like the way He saved Musa alayhi salam and Bani Israel of then, the Muslim then. Allah Rabbul Izzah, He says, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is how we save the believing men and women. You have to be firm and certain that Allah Rabbul Izzah will save you from the calamity or deal you are going through. This is just a small reminder of the opportunities Allah represent for us. So what needs to happen is you need to be making a lot of du'as. A lot of du'as. Don't stay away from making du'a. Shaitan wants to disturb and make a problem to your life. Do not allow that. وآخر دعوانا والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.